Hi, good morning guys. It's me, Santi. This time I'm with a water pump. An induction motor driven water pump. Let's open this one up and see what's inside and study it. Not this one. I have got an old pump with me. What's going on inside? How this one works? When we look at the water pump, it's divided into two sections. This side is an induction motor and this side is a water pump, which is connected by a central shaft. This induction motor gives the power to ride the water pump, and the water pump section pumps the water.
This is the inlet of the water pump. Water comes to the pump through this way. And this is the outlet of the pump. So our water comes through this way and gets some energy from the pump and goes out through this way.
Come on, let's open it up. Before opening the pump, let's examine the outside of the pump. I told you this side is an induction motor and this cylinder here is a capacitor. This is a single phase induction motor, it needs a capacitor to run. And this side is the water pump, it's a centrifugal water pump. The pump is connected to the motor by a shaft here. When the motor rotates, the pump also rotates. I'm planning this video in two sections. The first section we will open the centrifugal pump side and try making a centrifugal pump ourselves. And in the second section we will open the induction motor side, single phase induction motor side, and I will explain how the induction motor works. Okay, let's open. So guys, this is one old water pump I have got here. I have already unscrewed it. We are going to study the water pump section, the centrifugal pump section this time. Let's open it. When you open the pump, you can see a disc here. This disc is called impeller. This is an open impeller. There are many type of impellers, we will go after that also. The impeller is set inside a small casing like this. The casing is called volute casing. An impeller looks almost like this. A metallic disc with elevated curved metallic lines starting from the center and then running towards the periphery. These lines are called vanes of the impeller. Our impeller is going to rotate in this direction, like this. As we know, every rotating body has a tendency to move outwards. Such a force acts on a rotating body. That force is called centrifugal force. Same centrifugal force acts here. Before we start the pump, we will prime the pump. Priming of the pump is nothing but pouring enough water through the inlet of the pump till the water reaches the foot valve and the pump is fully filled with water. So that when we start the pump, the impeller is immersed in water. The volute casing is full of water. When we start the pump, impeller is going to rotate in this direction and the inlet is at the center of the impeller. Water, there is water here. The impeller is going to rotate in this direction very fast. So the water at the center is going to be pushed outwards, radially outwards, pushed outwards because of the rotational motion and the centrifugal force acting on that water. When the water goes out, the curved vanes will direct the water in this direction and the water which is gone will create a negative pressure here at the center of the impeller, so that more and more water is going to be sucked into the center of the impeller. That means a continuous flow happens. And impeller is carrying water to the volute casing, which is collected by the volute casing. If you look, you can see that volute casing is not a perfect circle. It begins with a lesser volume and the volume gradually increases till it reaches the end, till it reaches the outlet of the pump. That is because here the volute has to collect only the water from this vein, from the veins here, and the water travels here. More and more water is going to be added to the volute, so there should be an increase in volume. Finally, more and more water is going to be added with a lot of kinetic energy and the water reaches here. The kinetic energy of the water is going to turn into pressure here, except to the walls of the outlet, except to the walls of the line. The kinetic energy of the water is going to turn into pressure here. That's how a pump works. So guys, we are going to make a small water pump ourselves.
Guys, we are going to set up our little pump. in a 2-inch sized PVC casing. This is 4mm PVC sheet. We will draw a circle to make the impeller and cut it out. This is a small sample I tried to make. We are going to make one like this. We will draw some quarter circles on this disc. Now we will cut out some PVC to make the vanes of the impeller. You can cut the PVC sheet to the shape of the vanes. Use a screwdriver for this. Let's see whether it works.
This is a 2-inch PVC pipe. I'm going to use this 2-inch PVC pipe as the valve. This is our impeller. We need only this much size of the PVC pipe to make the valve. So let's cut it out. So this is our PVC piece. Our plan is to make a valve casing. So this is a 2-inch PVC end cap. And this is a 2 to 1 inch PVC pipe reducer. We fit it like this, we will get a cabin like this. It's a closed cabin. We don't need this much size, we should reduce the size. So guys, our valve casing is ready. This was our plan. Guys, we are going to use a 12 volt DC motor instead of an induction motor in our pump. So let's set it up. Let's put a hole in the middle of this one. Make a hole like this at the center of the end cap so that we can pass this part of the motor through it tightly. Let's check the impeller whether it rotates. Oh, it's rotating. And make two holes like this so that we can screw in the DC motor. Another problem we are going to encounter is that the water from this cabin can pass through the hole and can destroy your motor. We should make this cabin water sealed. For making this one water sealed, you can use a cycle tube for giving a proper water seal. So guys, let's fix our DC motor into this.
After we assemble this, this is our water inlet. Now we need to make an outlet. For that, we will make a hole here and we are going to use an hose connector. And we are going to use an hose connector to make the outlet. Fix it while it is still hot. You will get a proper seal and use some glue to settle it. Our water pump is almost ready.
Now we will fix the impeller. Thank you. So guys, our water pump is almost ready. Let's see whether it works or not. So guys, our centrifugal pump is pumping a little water. I meant to explain how a centrifugal pump works. Next week, we will go to the next section of the video. That's a single phase induction motor. And if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. I'll bring another video next week. Until then, bye.